Joshua and Clem. We didn't pay no rent, we just broke in. It was the place, first time, last time, only time I ever tried heroin. Never tried it before, so I did the first shot. I fell and hit the floor. Couldn't get up, thought I died. My mind left my body. Looking down from above, my friend saying, "Jeff, are you right?" Room was spinning round and round. After a while, I finally came back down into my body. I had such a great time. 3 days of diarrhea and vomiting. What a great high. Round the corner lived my friend, my friend Charlene. She lived in the basement of the house there on high on heroin and drunk on alcohol. And she said, "You shine and I just wanna shine too, but I feel so small." I got some bad news for you. Charlene died from an overdose in San Francisco. The batch, it was too strong. It killed 4 other people that weekend. My friend's death was just a spike in a statistical trend. Next thing I know, I'm in the People's Park, up in Brooklyn. And up runs Alvie Jones, saying, "Help me, please." Said a girl died in the house last night, right next to me. And I thought we should go back, get her backpack, give it to her family. I went to the house on 60th Street, and it was explained to me. The last day and a half, she had trouble breathing. I stood in the house and thought to myself, is there really a high so debilitating? It could cause a house full of people to wait a day and a half to deal with an emergency. Emergency. a spike into my veins. Heroin, will you be my next dead friend when I get the call? And I don't feel like a man at all, I feel like a broken child, drowning in pain. Next thing I know, I'm in Santa Rosa. Get a call from JT. He said Ryan's in a coma. He did too much and stopped breathing. We went down to the hospital to talk to his family. Doctor said the MRI looks bad. We detect no brain activity. We talked to his mom, Jane. His dad was kneeling by the bed praying. We came to learn the next day was her birthday. She had a decision to make. We came back the next day. We brought candles and a cake, but there was no way to make it okay. She had to give the go-ahead to remove her son from life support on her birthday. Happened again just last week. I got a message from them. Says Curtis passed away from an OD. I saw him back in February. He had a few months. I guess one is too many and a thousand is never enough for a dope fiend like me. He hadn't used for a few months, maybe more. He did the first shot, he fell and hit the floor and died. And that's the end of the story. A thousand is too much and one is too many. I remember watching Curtis make all the kids dance. I remember seeing the patch on his pants. I remember thinking at least since he got clean, at least it won't happen to him. It won't happen to him. To him. Heroin, I know just not to begin. Lou Reed said I feel like a man when I stick the spike into my vein. Heroin, tell me will you be my next dead friend when I get the call? And I don't feel like a man at all, I feel like a broken child, drowning in pain. Do me a big favor, if you're gonna be a junkie, go down to the Red Cross and learn CPR. Do me a big favor, if you're gonna be a junkie, when your friend goes out, don't fuck around in the bathtub. Don't try to walk her around. Don't try to shoot him up with salt water. Don't try to hit him with coke or speed. Make the call 911, administer breathing. Make the call 911, administer breathing. Administer breathing. Administer breathing. Administer breathing. Heroin. I don't know just where to begin. The song says I feel like a man when I stick the spike into my vein. Heroin, tell me, will you be my next dead friend when I get the call? I don't feel like a man at all. I feel like a broken child, drowning in pain.